Hi, I'm Di Heuser from PLR Planners and Booker Day System. And what I'm going to do today is a couple of people have asked me, some people seem to be battling with inserting JPEG images into Microsoft Word. So I'm going to go through the process. I'm going to show you how to insert the Booker Day templates, and then I'm going to show you how to insert other images like a PNG, for an example, and how you can move it around. Okay, so you'll see I've got a Microsoft Word document open. I've set this up as an 8x10 standard document, and I've got the margins mirrored, which is now ready for a standard book in terms of what we're going to be producing in terms of planners. Okay, so first things first is I'm going to change my view to one page so that you can see it all. And then I'm also going to turn on the grid line so that you can see currently what my margins look like. Now that is too narrow for me, so I'm going to go back to the design, to the layout, and just change that. And go to margins and go to custom and make this the ones that I normally do. So that's the inside of the book and that's the outside of the book margin. Okay, so now the reason why we put the grid lines on is so that you can actually see what happens when you insert an image, where it's actually going to sit, and whether it's going to cause a problem with the bleeds or not. The other thing that I also do is I always turn on the paragraph mark. So just under your review button, you've got that little paragraph mark called show or hide. You need that on because you need to be able to see where your next page starts, where you're currently sitting in terms of the position on the page. Okay, so if I go in and I want to insert a standard Book a Day image, I'm going to go to insert, picture, and I'm going to find the pictures. And let's go and pick up a lined page, and I'll pick up an 8x10. So there are my different documents, my different JPEG templates. So because this is, if you have a look again over here, this is going to be a right-facing page. I could pick up an image that is sitting on the right. So let's take that one. I'll click on it and I'll say insert. So instantly what happens is it comes in and it pops itself there. Now, theoretically, you should have to do nothing else unless you want to put a text box on that, above that. So I'm going to leave that one as it is. And I'm going to insert a page. So let me just get a couple of pages in here. So I'll insert a couple of page breaks. Okay, and I'll come back to this first page. So let's take this one over here. And I'm going to put my mouse over there. And I'm going to go to insert picture. And I'll pick up that one. And as you can see, it instantly just drops it. Now, If I can't move it at the moment because it's formatted as a standard picture. But if you went to format wrap text and behind text, then you'd find you could move that image around. Okay, but you shouldn't need to move it around unless you want to put a text box on top of that. So if you're not going to be doing anything more to the page, then you can just leave the formatting as it is. And then you'd go down to the next page and insert the second one. So insert image. Picture, and we'll pick up that one. Now you can see I've picked up the other side of that one. Okay, and if I go to a slightly bigger view, there's your image with the lines and there's your picture, and you can see just at the bottom there is the bottom of the grid that's showing you that actually that image is fitting within the margins. Okay, that's step one. You can also go in and you can add an image. Let me go back to a one page view where you can go in and you can add something pretty like a frame for the front page. So I'll go back to insert pictures and I'll pick up these pretty frames over here so I can change them to a slightly bigger font thing. So now I've got some pretty PNG files that I can use. So let's try that one. So I'll just click on it and you can either double click it or click on insert. So now what happens is you can see, you can actually still see the background because this is a transparent PNG. And in this case, it's simply slotted the image to the left. So if you go home, you could make it center. Or alternatively, you can then go and format it and turn the text to format behind the text so that you can then move it around. But as you can see, the whole image fits perfectly within my grid lines, which means now that I don't have an issue with it going over my margins. Okay. I don't know if that has made it any clearer for you. If it hasn't, please just give me a shout and let me know.